I'm currently reviewing a couple of entry-level 3D printers, and one of them showed, even in vase mode, these weird blobs randomly on the surface. Let me show you how I fixed this problem with a slicer setting I'm sure not many of you have ever touched. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. So many viewers are constantly asking what a good entry-level 3D printer is. So I currently have the Ender 3 Pro and the Alfawise U30 Pro running side by side in a comparison test. This review will be released at some point in the future, but I thought I'd share with you how I was able to get rid of these blobs on the surface of the U30 Pro prints, because the solution is, I think, a bit out of the ordinary. You often see these printing artifacts at the location where the printing move of a parameter ends and the build-up pressure in the extrusion system pushes more material out of the nozzle before the pressure is relieved by the retraction move. This is mostly fixed by coasting, wiping or higher retractions, though in this case where I noticed it, it was on a vase where the wall was printed in a spiral, so theoretically at a constant speed of the print head, without any retractions or similar. Upon closer inspection, I noticed that in reality though, the printhead stuttered from time to time, where again, the build-up pressure in the Bowden system leads to these blobs. But why? The G-code also didn't show any real problems or backward moves, especially since the model is a really nice and smooth vase. But here's actually the problem, because during slicing, each of the facets will be translated into one linear move, resulting in a lot of very small motions. I know a similar problem from my CNC router, because it can also reach its full speed and start stuttering if the individual moves are too small, and have it even seen happening with Octoprint that wasn't able to stream movement commands fast enough for gyroid infill. The mainboard is not able to handle reading or receiving and processing the individual commands fast enough, so at some point the machine starts to slow down and, in this case, extrudes a little wider due to the pressure in the system. For the print quality of a Bowden extruder 3D printer, it would be optimal if the material feed rate would always be constant. Direct extruders are a bit better in that regard. To be honest, this shouldn't happen nowadays with a printer, and the moves are not horribly tiny, and also, the Ender 3 prints the same G-code file flawless. Regardless of that fact, I'm now going to show you how I simply fixed this problem with, I think, a quite unknown slicer setting on which I haven't found a lot of information around. If you have ever used it, let me know in the comments. So what Cura and most other slicers offer is a resolution setting. This setting, which doesn't always work the same, basically merges individual moves into one if they are below the specified length, effectively reducing the size of the G-code file and making moves more smoothly. In order to see the setting in Cura, select the gear icon, scroll to mesh fixes, or in older versions experimental, and activate maximum resolution and maximum deviation. The tooltip already says that this is to help that the printer can keep up speed. Maximum resolution defines the minimum length of a line segment, maximum deviation the maximum error that is allowed by the simplification. This means that Cura tries to merge segments if they are smaller than the defined value, but if the geometrical difference would get bigger than the defined deviation, it will also allow smaller print moves. For the Ender 3 profile and many other predefined Cura profiles, these were all set to 0.05 mm, which is for deviation an okay value, but for the resolution, pretty small. In the worst case, this would mean that a printer running at 60 mm a second would need to process up to 1200 commands per second, which will definitely overload the processor, at least the old 8-bit ones. Though, looking at the Ultimaker 3 profile for example, showed me that they were using a maximum resolution 10 times as big. The Ultimaker 5S even sets it to 0.7 mm. How does that change the G-code? Since this is not your regular 3D printing channel, we'll also take a look at some data. For that I sliced Buddy, once with a stock 0.05 mm resolution and once at the resolution that the Ultimaker 3 also uses, which is 0.5 mm. I loaded the G-code into Excel and with some formula magic calculated the length of each print move and plotted them in a histogram. All in all, I analyzed around 10,000 lines and the bars now show us how many print moves have a length in a specific range For example, 0.12 to 0.14 mm or 0.4 to 0.42 mm. For the baseline G-code, we can see that most print moves really have a quite small length, again, especially because the model itself was really fine to begin with. It peaks at around 0.16 mm. There is also, by the way, a small individual peak at the side. And can you guess what that is? It's our wipe distance of 0.4 mm. Pretty cool! When we take a look at the histogram of the G-code sliced with 0.5 mm resolution, we can see that the peak has moved from 0.16 mm to the assigned 0.5 mm. We still have some smaller print moves remaining due to our maximum deviation criterion. Still, I think we were able to remove quite a lot of small print moves, which is also visible in the size of the G-code. But in the end, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Or rather here, the printing of the G-code. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy this kind of content, make sure to leave a like, subscribe and hit the bell icon. And really, the print moves of the vase are totally smooth and so is the printing result. And also, all of the sits on body are gone. So we've really succeeded. Nice! This might slightly alter the dimensions of the model, so don't use values too high, especially for deviation. Still, in my case, I couldn't see a negative impact on the print quality with the 0.5 mm value that I used. The guys from Ultimaker also probably had a reason to use it. This is definitely not the solution of all of your printing problems, and in this case might be really more evident because the firmware of the Alfawise seems to be acting up a little. But if you have strange phenomenons during printing and notice that the moves are not smooth, try playing around with that parameter and you might be surprised about the results. Let me know in the comments if you've ever noticed and played around with that setting, and if so, what your results were and which values you can recommend. Thanks for watching this rather short video for once. I still hope you enjoyed it and learned something. If so, then please leave a like and make sure that you're subscribed to the channel. If you want to support my work, become a patron or a YouTube member, or find many more ways in the video description. For more interesting content, please check my video library where you can find additional interesting things. See you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.